Hello guys, welcome back to the class for orals. Today we are discussing what actions are to be taken if oil has entered in the hot well or cascade tank. Please watch this video till end. It has got important points covered. First of all, we have to find out the source of leakage, and then we have to rectify the fault from where the oil is coming. And in the cascade tank, we have to observe the observation tank properly. One of the reasons of oil getting into the hot well is the steam heating coil having hole. Let us suppose this is the steam heating coil. It is having hole in it. Now, the steam pressure is higher than the oil pressure. Because of this hole and steam high pressure, the steam can easily enter into the oil side, and oil cannot enter into the steam pipeline. But if the steam heating coil is shut, that means the steam pressure is zero. Now, by the oil head pressure, the oil can easily enter into the steam heating coil. That means the oil will enter if there is no steam pressure, and oil will find its way to the hot well. This is how the oil will enter into the hot well or cascade tank. Now we have to check the steam trap return line. Every oil heater return line is having the steam trap. We have to open the drain of each steam trap, take the sample from that. From that sample, we will come to know from where the oil is coming into the hot well. Mainly the oil is coming from the heaters. That is the main engine fuel oil heater, boiler fuel oil heater, lube oil heater. And because of the oil pressure being higher, they can be the tube leakage. In that condition, we have to find out which tube is leaking. We have to rectify the tube and we have to plug the tube like in this figure. Next, we have to check the condition of the oil which we have seen in the observation tank. Suppose it is lube oil, then we have to check the lube oil purifier heater outlet valve. We have to take the sample from the drain and we have to analyze it later on. And if suppose that oil is fuel oil, that means we have to check the main engine fuel oil heater and fuel oil purifier heater. And we have to take the sample from both main engine fuel oil heater sample and fuel oil purifier heater sample. Additionally, the boiler fuel oil heater return line and the fuel oil tank heating outlet or the return have to be checked also. You can see in this diagram. Now the next action we have to take is to use the oil absorbent pads, which is very much used in the oil absorbing floating on the water. Next, a towel like filter sponge should also be checked. This towel like filter sponge is provided in the hot well for separating the chambers. It is for removing the oil contained in the condensed water, and the wear is provided. The condensed water passes through the sponge and the wear. Then the oil is removed and only the clear condensed water is discharged from the cascade tank. The next action we have to take is to do the scum blowdown. We have to perform the scum blowdown by skimming it from the top of the overboard by funnel and then overflowing the hot well and then draining the scum. You can see on the right figure there is an overflow line, and on the left there is a funnel provided to collect the scum. You have to check for oil contamination detector or OCM, which is given for giving the alarm if any kind of oil is entering in the hot well. One of the first preventive actions to be taken when oil is leaking into the feed water system is to take a look at the cascade or hot well tanks. If oil is found in the last compartment of the hot well, just entering before the feed water system, it is recommended to check the boiler water gauge glass, whether the oil is there in the gauge glass or not. If there is oil, then we should not do the bottom blowdown. We have to do only the scum blowdown of boiler for several times. If the boiler bottom blowdown is done, then the boiler will be completely covered in the oil. Next, we have to take the boiler water sample and we have to perform the water sample test.